Today, we're going to look at the Cholesky decomposition and how it can help you with simulations. Hey, welcome back to my channel. My name is Tino, aka The Dirty Quant. If this is the first time here, I usually cover maths, statistics, finance, all good stuff like that. So, what I'd like to look at today is something called the Cholesky decomposition. Bit of a scary name, but really, really useful. So I'm a big fan of doing simulations, Monte Carlo simulations, and I guess the whole point behind them is you have to add an element of realism in terms of how the various, let's just say, financial assets, behave together. So the Cholesky decomposition allows you to sprinkle a touch of sort of correlation through to these assets and just makes it that little bit more close to reality, right? So you've got to have it, it's always a treading a thin line where you've got to make the simulation appear, random enough, but also have characteristics of the real world, right? So pretty useful. So let's just fire up a Jupyter notebook and we'll have a look how to use it. All right, super, super easy. So I think it's important for backtesting and especially for, trying to overfit a time series. So, we don't want to overfit because otherwise, that backtest is only specific to that event. Even if you're using real life data, right? The issue is that history will never repeat itself. You cannot have a time machine and go through those events again. So what you're trying to do is to create your own time series that has those characteristics and then see, does my trading model actually do well through it? So you want to simulate data that has similar characteristics and see, does my model perform well? Cholesky decomposition, it introduces correlation between the assets and lets you have just something a little bit more complete, a little bit more true to life. So I'll show you how it works. So pretty easy here. So let me just zoom in. What we're gonna do is just create a really simple array. And this is just a matrix, a correlation matrix, one on the diagonal, and then just 0.7 for everything else, right? So simple 3x3, so three assets, right? So this is what it looks like. You have a correlation matrix, one on the diagonal and 0.7 everywhere else, right? Pretty straightforward, so far so good. So what the Cholesky decomposition does, right? It gives you this, if I sort of just run, from NP. Linear algebra Cholesky core, you get this sort of this one half of the Cholesky decomposition. It looks quite peculiar, but it has this really, really special characteristic. If I get that decomposition, that little matrix that it just spat out, and multiply it by the transpose, I can regenerate or recreate the original correlation matrix, right? So child times child transpose, you get the original correlation matrix. So I'm just gonna do it here, np.mapmul, so multiply matrix multiplication, multiply those, and it's recreated that matrix, right? So you think, well, that's all well and good. How do I actually use this? I actually just had a look at Mr. Cholesky. Have had quite an interesting life story. Unfortunately, he perished in the First World War, but he was actually a soldier. And, the Cholesky, sort of all of his works were actually found posthumously. So after he actually died. So very, very interesting story. So back to the decomposition. How do we use it for simulation? So let's say I want to simulate some random data, right? So I'm going to be using my typical normal distribution here, np random.normal, and this just gives us a standard normal. So zero mean, a one standard deviation, one variance, right? I can actually put in the size, so three assets, 1,000 long, so 1,000 observations, right? And I get this random data, right? So it doesn't really look like much. And if I just run the correlation matrix of it, you can sort of see obviously one on the diagonal as expected, and everything else is pretty close to zero. I mean, you obviously have some sort of deviations, but it should just be zero. Essentially, the data is uncorrelated, as expected, right? It's just generating random data, and it has a no correlation structure. Any of this is essentially noise. If I were to rerun it, it would be a completely different value, right? If I just sort of show you what a plot of something like this looks like, it's something like this. And you can, you know, make up your mind. You think, well, I can sort of start to see patterns and you know, in the data and what have you. But if you actually go back to the original return series, I know that the data is uncorrelated, right? There is no correlation in this data, right? But even though you think, oh, well, at the beginning, all three assets went down, and then, you know, humans like to create a little story around events, right? What you can actually do is multiply the Cholesky decomposition by the random data, and that will actually introduce correlation to the data. So really, really straightforward, just using, again, the MP matrix multiplier, Cholesky times random data, and then I'm just going to put it directly into a data frame. So looks like something like this. Yeah, pretty straightforward. You can't really see the correlation, but if I go and plot it, all of a sudden, you know, this does actually have a correlation structure. And you might think, well, am I sort of going through, am I seeing the similar effects that I was, you know, before, where I'm sort of imagining that there is a correlation structure? Well, if I just look at this sim call rets and then use the pandas correlation function, I can see that, you know, very, very close to having 0.7 correlation. Again, there's always an element of noise, right? 0.7 is like your target, but you're gonna sort of deviate around it. And this is just a 1,000 observations. If I were to extend it, that correlation, that error would shrink down. Pretty, pretty cool. Let's try and make it a little bit more interactive, a little bit more visual. So I'm just gonna run this. Cool, so we have this little, I guess it's sort of a mini applet. And what we have at the top, a few sliders that lets us pick the number of securities, the correlation that we want for that matrix. So look, you can obviously have a different correlation structure, rather than everything being filled with the same number. The idea being that you would get your correlation from, you know, real life data and plug it in and then use the Cholesky decomposition. But for the purpose of this toy example, everything has the same correlation, and then sort of be able to pick the sample size. So it's quite nice. I say, look, I want four assets. I can just sort of increase it, and the plot updates in real time. Same with this, the correlation, I can say drag it down to say, 0.25, and those, the numbers are essentially completely uncorrelated. If I drag that up towards one, they start to really tighten up. Obviously, correlation starts to converge towards one. So yeah, the correlation can't actually be one, because otherwise it is not a definite. So, you know, I had to limit it to 0.99, but yeah, quite nice. You can start to experiment and see what does it look like. And obviously each time you run it, random data, every time it's different, increase the sample size, quite nice. You know, even up to 3,000 observations, you know, close to sort of, over 10 years if you sort of just look at trading days. So, you know, really, really long sort of patterns. Just quite nice to play around. So look, this was the Cholesky decomposition. I hope you found it useful. It's a great tool, really simple to apply, really simple to implement. It has essentially no computational overhead, and it just makes your back tests just that little bit more robust and more, I guess, eliminates that sort of that bias that is always sort of introduced when using back tests. Hope you enjoyed the episode. Catch you in the next one. Bye.